Have you ever heard this sound? This sound represents the SOS signal in Morse code, where the letter S is represented by three dots and the letter O by three dashes. What is Morse code? Why would we want to hear a letter? What does it have to do with binary trees? This is what we're gonna see in this video. First of all, what is Morse code? Morse code is an encoding method where every character is represented by a sequence of dots and dashes, and it's widely used because of its ease of expression. We can express it by using sound, light, radio waves, and many other ways. So for example, if you're lost in a forest, no, not this one, a real forest, you can ask for help by performing the SOS signal with your light torch by turning it on and off like this. Okay, but what does this have to do with binary trees? Imagine that we have an empty string, and we want to see what characters do we get by adding dots and dashes. If we add a dot, we get the character that is represented by one dot, which is the letter E, and if we add a dash, we get the letter T. Now in the case where we added a dot, if we add a dot again, we get dot dot, which represents the letter I, and if we add a dash, we get dot dash, which represents the letter A. In the case where we added a dash at the beginning, by adding a dot we get N, and by adding a dash we get M. And we can continue with this logic until we reach characters that are represented with 5 dots or dashes, and in reality we made the Morse tree. We made a tree where if we go to the left it means that we have a dot, and if we go to the right it means that we have a dash, so we can use it to decode a character in Morse. For example, we have this sequence. We have a dot so we go to the left, then a dash so to the right, and a dash again, and we get the letter W. Or with this one, we go right, left, and we get the letter C. Now that we know how to decode a character, we can move to how to decode the whole Morse string, but before you have to know something about spaces in Morse. We said that our character is represented by a sequence of dots and dashes, so if we want to write two characters in Morse, we have to separate their respective sequences with a space, because otherwise, the sequence can have different possible meanings, so we wouldn't know how to decode it. But to separate words we put a slash, which can be expressed by an absence of sound that is longer than the one between characters. Okay, time to decode now. A Morse string is made of different sequences separated by spaces, so the idea is to split our string with a space as separator, then for each sequence, if it's slash, then we just add a space to our decoded string, else we use our Morse tree to decode the sequence of dots and dashes into a character and we add it. Before moving to the code, please take some seconds to like the video and to subscribe to the channel, if you want to do so obviously. Let's move to the code now. The first function that we're gonna make decodes one single character, and in reality we will just traverse the Morse tree until the end of the sequence. The function takes as parameters the Morse tree, the sequence, and uses I to traverse it. The base case is when we reach the end of the sequence, it means that we are on the node that contains the character represented by our sequence. We return it. Else if the actual character is a dot, we said that we go to the left, so we call the function again, but by passing the left child and I plus 1 to move to the next character of the sequence. Else if it's a dash, we go to the right, so we call with right child and I plus 1. Now we can move to the one that decodes the encoded string. It takes the Morse tree and the string as parameters. Then we create a string decoded, and we split str to get the sequences. Now for each sequence, if it's a slash, we said that it's just the space that separates words, so we add a space to decode it. Else, we have to decode it with the function we made now. This is why we called and we add the returned character to decode it. After the loop, we just return the decoded string. Before ending this video, I want to answer a question. How is the Morse alphabet made? At first glance, we may think that we assign sequences randomly, but in reality, there is an inverse relationship between the frequency of a character in the English language and the length of its sequence in Morse, because we want messages to be as short as possible. This is why we gave small sequences to frequent letters. For example, occurrences of the letter E are very frequent, so its sequence is short. It's the opposite for the letter Y. This is why we gave it a longer sequence. We reached the end of this video. Tell me in comments if you enjoyed it, and see you in the next one.